So I'm gonna make this out of the giant eel that we've already made. I've sized up some fangs for him. I'm gonna transfer the fangs onto this piece of foam. It's a nice thick piece of upholstery foam. And I will coat it. Oh, and you guys are gonna say notifications are on. Okay, there we go. Hey, Big Dog and Hugo and Christine Salvati and Mario, Michelle Schulte and Misty, hi. Okay. Again, I'm making a big snake head out of a giant eel head that's in the other room. Right now, I'm just working on the fangs. When you're working on something that has a curve to it, use the curve, use the radius that your wrist naturally does. Like, you know, so figure that out. If you need to be smaller, hold the pen shorter and you'll get a nice smaller curve. So use your physiology to your advantage. I'm just letting the curve of my wrist do all the work, the natural arc that happens. My snake fangs. Let's get us on all comments. I will try and keep up with comments. Most everybody is just saying hello, it seems. Except for Dead Mike. He says, "What's up?" Because he is a child of the 90s. I would assume. Okay. There we go. And I'm just working, guys. That's it. Spent my morning listing a few things for sale. I'm wondering how well our bandsaw gets pressed in this, or if it'll get caught up and cause a problem. Find out together and possibly lose a hand. These are stilts that I have to move because I get my stilts delivered to here. Because I don't have a loading dock at my home. Safety glasses. I'm wearing them because I'm at work, and insurance-wise, I need everybody else to wear them at work. Oh, that's good. Right, Rube? Okay. There we go.
Cobwebs, you do throw a lot of stuff.
So, I see where they're coming from on that. All right, I have two fangos now that I will trim and cut. I'm gonna grab some scissors. I think a scissor trimming is probably all these guys need.
I officially hate this mix.
Why is it? Is it like 27.2? Oh, 45A to 100B. Yeah, enjoy that. That's what I just go 50 to 100 and don't let it drip out of the can. Okay, dump is done. Don't let it drip. Mold room. That is the eel that will be turning into a nake. A nake. Then the nakes. Sorry if I'm making you seasick. No one saw me lose a finger. That's good. All right.
Boy, that would have gotten me a lot of problems.
So many views.
So many views.
He can make 9 more videos. So I cut the profile for this. And now I'm just cutting off 45s. Hello, Paul Bennett. Yeah, but good effort there, Rue. Okay, and something else, you're gonna develop a style and a technique to this. So don't finish this one before you even start on this one. So you'll see me bounce back and forth quite a bit. It'll get pretty difficult to keep them on track, you know what I mean? Matching one after you're done sucks. I'm just knocking the 45 off of this. They already look a lot rounder than they did before. And right now, I'm gonna clean up a little bit. I don't want this mess to get away from me. Okay, now I look for the hardest corners, and I'm just gonna use these scissors to knock off the hardest corners. So I'm going to take this from an object with four planes, and then I made it an object with eight planes, and now I'm going to make it an object with 32 planes. And eventually I'll do that, and it'll become visually undistinct from round. This is just upholstery foam. This is regular old couch upholstery foam. If I had a mold, then I would do this out of like AB foam. And you actually can sand this. So I may take this to the sander in a minute, but I'm actually pretty happy with that because of the coatings and stuff that I put on it. I think it'll be fine. And I'm going to lose a little bit of length because that 45 carries all the way down into that tooth, and that's okay. It's part of it. What you looking for, Rue? You need the arbor. I much prefer this to like polystyrene foam, so. There you go. This is for Jake the Snake Roberts. That's who this is for. You guessed it on your first try. Go to the belt sander just to see if I destroy these. Note which way, because I don't want to go against it, I want to go with it. I'd say that is appreciably softer on this one than on this one. So let's do that again. And that technique I like a lot better. I'm gonna do that on this one. That's now nice and soft and papered. I like it. I'm going to make these a little more rounded. better. Now I can drill into that foam and really mount these well. Got to be careful using a belt sander for distressing costumes. It can grab, so just be careful. Let it go. Hey, Rude, you want to build a snowman? Great, see you tonight. Great, see you tonight. I have my Nick fangs, and I'm gonna bring my eel in here. I think that'll be the easiest thing to do. Much better, yes, indeed. Okay, I'll be right back. I'm gonna bring a giant eel with me.
These days.
So I wanted to keep this from rocking, and I thought, I'll just grab that piece of wood right there and use this piece of wood to keep this from rocking. Then I realized this whole mold would fall over, and that's bad. Someone explained to Paul, there is a piece of expanded metal, which is a grid, welded to this frame. We drop that in, we foam around it, and it has a lot of grab onto that expanded metal. Right here now, I hear Ivan working with the air compressor guy who is here for maintenance. And a lot of people say that we have a lovely air compressor. We do. But just to have one that size and that does what it does, it can be $20,000 in maintenance a year. If you look all the way down this hallway, see that air tank? That's for air compressor. And you see that? That's a door. We have a big air compressor. A lot of maintenance on those, though. And I cut out, or I traced the end of this so I can cut the latex, and then I'll be able to stuff up inside of it. Latex is very thick. I'm gonna grab some other scissors. I'm a monster dentist. So yeah, I'm a monster dentist. That's what I do. Monster dental things. The danger is that I won't cut straight, and that will cause the tooth to angle. And I don't want to have to fight it. That's what I want. It's the one that I want. Woo, woo, woo. I get it, man. You think I need a hole? Let's use a hole saw. But a jigsaw is just the way to go with a barrel. Because it's round. There's that bit of fun.
And it's definitely one of those ones. But I spent so long getting the harbor on it.
Yeah, 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 forget that. How did teeth come out on that version of the eel? Okay.
Bottoms are minorly deflating in a couple of spots. Oh, really?
So there I was, down to my first knuckle in this eel. Okay, we did it.
Up to my elbows in the eel.
Well, you were up to your elbows.
You did put fangs on it.
I did.
You said you weren't.
I was wrong. I said I wasn't going to, and the reference material said, yes, you are. Oh, yes, yeah. You are. Yeah, so now I have a fangy eel, which will be more snake-like. I'm going to coat the fangs in latex. Good afternoon, everybody. Okay, that's right. Ain't no party like a big eel party, because a big eel party don't snake, but it has to snake. Head bumps. I'm gonna have to make those out of something. I have to go here, and I think I can do it just with this extra foam that I've got. So there is such a thing as extra foam, just so you know. No such thing as extra money. So what I'm going to do next.
No such thing as extra chocolate.
Extra what?
Chocolate.
There is no such thing as extra chocolate. That's also correct.
Or cheeseburgers.
There can be extra. There can be tomorrow's cheeseburgers.
Not extra.
Someone made tomorrow's cheeseburgers today. That's how that happens. All right, so yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and make this head mump. I'm gonna make two because he needs two, because he has two halves of his head. Feels about right. Oh, those are good. Rue is showing off his teeth here.
Ah.
Hey, let me see that. Because I won't be able to see a thing.
How does this look? Hold on. That's actually pretty awesome. Like, that's a character right there.
I'm
taking a picture. Hold on.
What?
You didn't hold on. I said I was taking a picture for
you. I also can't hear, by the way. So. Allow me to slip into something more comfortable.
Also known as my eel. Okay.
Okay, little arms hanging off the side would be so cute. That's
actually
great.
No, I just like itself. It's an eel man. You know, eels don't have arms.
Eel man. Here you go.
Let's see if we do it.
Five.
Five? We need five now?
We need five now. Yeah.
Hey, my wife is here.
She's awesome.
That would be, okay, one on an arm that just pops out of the hole coming at you, and then one that actually comes out biting you on the side of it. Ha!
Remember the bandsaw? Let's do that again. Hello, wife. So here's a side effect of the pandemic. I was at home so long. When I'm at work, I miss my wife. Like, I just want to hang out with her. You need help with something, what? Okay. Okay, so this is the rigid jigsaw. It is the most non-ergonomic jigsaw known to man. And there's a picture of the blade going up and down.
Yeah.
So this, you'd think this button makes the blade go
up
and down.
No, that's how the blade comes in and out.
Up here, and it oddly has to warm up. Like, so if you're like, is this the on switch? Oh no, that's just the light. You have to let it go for a second.
That's what I did.
Yeah. There you go, enjoy.
That's dumb.
Now this is actually, this is the dumbest tool I've seen. And it is so uncomfortable for your hand. It's like, here, put your finger in the blade, because that's the best way to hold this. Note, I don't have one of those at my home shop, only at dark hour. Reading all these quotes or comments. Okay, so yes, all right, I want you to make a note though. I did lean over to pick up a piece of foam that fell by the saw. Did you note that when I did, I wasn't looking down at what I was picking up. I turned and I looked at the saw and then I felt around with my hand until I found it. Because look at the tool that's moving really fast. Don't look on the ground for the foam. So these are my head mumps. I'm gonna cut them on a bevel, not the way you would think. Well, I'm gonna bevel the same way you think. I'm not going to apply them the way that you think.
I made you a beautiful artist palette.
Thank you, Rue. for this beautiful artist palette. Wasn't this 100 times easier? Even with that crappy saw?
Yes. Glad I had that idea.
I'm keeping this at like a 45 from my parallel corner here. You're just staring at me. You're weird. I'm just clearing off this so I can see. Hey, Rue, come here.
Hey, Rue, come here?
Yeah. I made you this.
A hat.
It is a hat, that's right. Of course I handed it to Rue after I said how dangerous of a tool it was. That's what we do here. Okay, that is not the top. This is rounded up. This is the bottom. And I glue the pieces down this way, and that is what gives me that beautiful mumpy shape and a smooth attachment point. So now this one was like this, so this one has to be like this. Yeah. The right and the left. This blade is holding up remarkably well. We don't have a lot of these here at Dark Gallery, so I'm glad. Paul Bennett said you look like you were wearing a kiddie toilet seat. It's not wrong. Yeah. My wife knows that anytime I go to the store, I'm gonna put something on my head and I'm gonna bang on something to tell what kind of noise it's gonna make because of who I am as a person. She knows, she's aware of this. We'll say it's a little warm today for a foam hat.
And if there's little dancing stuffed animal things, I'm going to press the buttons of every one of them and see what they do.
Right. I want to see how they move and stuff. Let's go to the makeup room and get some contact cement. It's like a field trip. We're staying in the same building. It's like a field trip. So oddly, we haven't like brought back full numbers, so it's a little quiet in here for me. I like a bit more of a bustle. Alexa, what time is it?
It's 12:06 p.m.
50 minutes till lunch. You guys want to see something? These are going to be a future YouTube Wednesday. These guys. And I might do this one as a future YouTube Wednesday too. I built these in the morning before our video shoot the other day. I can't leave without the contact cement. Hooray, field trips. Wait, Mimi, are you supposed to be in school right now? Because you cannot play hooky to do monster stuff. Well, you can, like I did that, but still. I was on work release. Smartest thing I ever did, by the way. I got the whole leave to go to a job from high school deal. Completely legal. My job was working at the haunted house. School starts September. Haunt ends in October. Free time off. Well, let's get a brush. Bigger shop means everything is spread out and you have to walk to get stuff. That's what that means.
Like, if I want a mock room, I have to
actually
do it through a walkie-talkie. Yeah, or go find them.
Painting these really good with contact cement, especially all the way down here on the edge.
Broken carving knife, round file.
Take this broken knife, just throw it away. Boom, 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 boom. Anybody remember the movies? I think they were in the 90s, where Bruce Willis was the voice of a baby. I don't know why that just popped into my head, but it did. Look who's talking. That's right. That's what it was. I saw that at the drive-in with at the same time as The Money Pit with Tom Hanks. And I don't know if they came out the same year or whatnot, or just the drive-in I went to. Reusing old movies. That's perfectly possible. It was Tom Hanks, The Money Pit, and Look Who's Talking. Now we figure out where they go on the snake head. Okay.
have it provided.
What?
Have you seen my totem pole?
He's special. I didn't realize the camera's there. Just standing there with my back to the camera, right in front of the camera.
You do that all the time. I'm like, who does that all the time? Oh yeah, it's you. You're the one who does that all the time.
Want to help me move my snake?
You know what? I got it.
It's really not that hard.
Need your character to hand in.
This is my test batch. See how well this expands.
Revelations trailer, which is a new cartoon that's going to be coming out soon. Now it's lower, I can see it better.
I might need minor assistance.
Okay.
Need you to hold the bag and do the top pressure well and make sure the mouth doesn't deform.
Okay.
Just can't cover both of these.
Let me put on this other side of glue.
It's gluey.
Then, if it's yellow, that means it's sticky glue. You know it's working.
Trying to help. Didn't work.
You helped him use me.
I was like, oh, here, let me grab that and bring it over to you so you can put glue on it. My brain didn't register. Yellow already has glue on it.
Okay, I think that's good. Now, what is my job?
Bag.
Oh, so I'm the one over top of the toxic fumes? Got it.
Or do you want to do mouth shape?
No.
I just figured you didn't want to get on the floor.
No, you reach under there and feel for bulging roundness. That's what I want you to do. You do that.
Why do I like him?
No, the only hole in this barrel is on that side.
Yeah.
How big of a batch are you doing?
400.
Are you doing just the front nose first?
I was going to do both of them at once.
Okay. I like to do it in smaller batches to control the ball with my foamy nose. This is another eel, by the way. This came out of the eel mold.
So the eel mold is right there. The eel head I'm working on is in there. Mm-hmm. And the Ivan is right there.
Man.
And then, so that's the eel mold. Rue pulled one out.
We put them in this garbage can, and that's latex shrinkage because it was sculpted over top of a blue barrel. Like, that was the sculpting bust I used, was a blue barrel. So it shrank enough where now it fits inside of the blue barrel. And I can see that Rue is now frantically mixing.
Al or Ivan.
Go ahead.
Warren Maxwell says, Ivan!
What's up, buddy?
AC guys on the roof, so if you hear people.
Okay. Don't worry about noises on the roof. Got it.
Rue has a hole in the bucket where he can feel the nose and stuff and make sure that the mouth doesn't pop out. And by not giving back pressure, I'm not giving it a reason to pop out. Warren says he also did a shout out to you, Rue. I did miss a phone call just now. It's okay. Jennifer, pew, pew, pew.
I think it's funny that you checked that because my phone didn't change your answer. This one actually needs the crown.
Right.
As opposed to making sure I get the crown in there.
That I'm going to cut off.
That doesn't need the crown.
On that side, this one's on this. We are waiting for them to dry a little more. They're faithful. While I'm waiting on those to dry, I think I'm going to cut his eyes off. So, these eyes are exactly where an eel's eyes would be. So, this is exactly where an eel's eyes would be. But a snake's eyes are actually going to be like closer to over here. They're a little further back. The nose is a little broader, so I'm going to have to take off these eyes and move them back 2 or 3 inches in order to get the right look. And this may frustrate some of you, but everything is a building material.
If this were a finished snake, it would be a spectacled cobra. Oh, with the spectacles? That's funny. Sorry. Won't happen again. Dark hour is kind of an evening. Now I can put these eyes anywhere that I need to make them more naked. For the record, yes, Jake did give you a reference with a completely different head shape than the eel that he ordered. So, thanks, Jake. Very thick latex skin on this. It has burlap in it for strength. That's how we can foam it outside of the mold, and it keeps its shape. Eyes off. Great, super. Cutting it the way that I did, I'm guaranteed to get a smoother edge as this contacts the head form.
And they're not quite coming up forward.
That's good. That's pretty soft.
Mm-hmm.
Softer than. Yeah.
And that's cheaper than the others.
Great. Yeah. Foam test. Now I'm getting a more snake-like look from head-on. I'm going to have to do that again, a whole nother piece, I think. Doing there is I'm building up these big mumps that the snake has on its head. I'm gonna have to do it one more time because I need them a little bigger, a little wider. Wider for sure, to make the back of the head wider. I'm gonna say the word wider one more time. I love my Harbor Freight pneumatic paint sprayer. I get them a lot. They're only like $15 or so, so why wouldn't I love them? What's not to love, as they say? And right now in my brain, I'm isolating what is this shape and how is it going to transfer into 2D? This time I'm going to cut one and then I'll flip it to cut the other. Let's all go to the bandsaw. Let's all go to the bandsaw. Let's all go to the bandsaw and cut ourselves some bone. keep your fingers away from the spinny Sharpie bits. This is the side that I traced, so I want that to be down because I'm doing a mirror image. I'm flipping. We're flipping. So in case anyone has just joined us, I'm turning a giant eel into a giant snake. Was a giant eel, will be a giant snake. These are foam pieces that are building up. The big bumps on their head that really tell you, really it's an adder. Adders have those big bumps more than other snakes, although some boas have them. Now, even if you just have a 55-gallon barrel, you can still build it up using shapes the same way, and foam and contact cement. You don't have to start with a giant eel prop. That was easier for me because I had one laying around. Gauge your ears. When you get old, they're going to look just like this. That's not true. I mean, it could be, like, if you go crazy with it, but when I cut it from the blue side. Blade is getting dull now. It's a miracle that it lasts this long. This is the Hanukkah blade of razor blades. Look how long it's lasting. I'm shocked. A little bit of drag though. Which is why I do a lot of the big cutting on the bandsaw. I don't want to make this blade duller than it needs to be.
And that cut got me most of the way through. So now I just rip that other half inch of foam, 3/8 or whatever. I am going to take that off too. I haven't put the eyes back on yet because I need to see where these land. And that's going to change some of the landmarks of the face. You guys spraying that third layer of trees yet, Kim?
No, but I mean, I'm getting white out of it.
Yeah.
But I have to stop because I'm still getting black. So I'm up to where he's at. And this is like
red. Yes. A lot of this, guys, is just me at work, so I will get called away and stuff every now and then. Let's get these set. This is a glue. What's that? Sure. Sure. I just want that width to be able to screw into it. And you don't have to fill it. You can just do like 2 inches of foam up the sides with the bag. Just do smaller batches. And then it won't weigh a metric ton. You might have a giant eel head laying around tank. Who knows?
Can't pop it when you have a second.
Might have a giant
head
laying around?
Eel head. Yeah, I think a lot of art is just learning how to see shapes in things and knowing what you have to do to get the shapes changed. This is kind of a pain in the butt to turn an eel into a snake, but it's also a fun challenge. I don't know exactly where I'm going to put these pieces that I made. I know they're going to be back here somewhere, but I'm just pinning everything because I got to skin this foam anyway. And having contact cement on it will make the next skin that I put on stick a little better. Thank you.
I'm going to leave them in. I'm leaving them in. Anacondas have teeth like that. I mean, some big snakes do. Well, some snakes do. So I'm going to leave the little teeth in. I took out the ones I needed to for the fangs to work.
Oh, you cut his eyes out.
Yeah. They were the wrong spots. And the last time you were here, his eyes were cut out. And you stared at him and you did not notice.
Maybe. Okay. You looked something up.
Yeah. You bad have to drop. Just making a giant eel, but I got other stuff cooking in the other room. Yeah, because you want this to be flush with the end. So this flipped up is going to be probably here. So yeah, you have to cut that. Ideally, you want it like half an inch under the flap.
Half an inch under the flap?
Yeah, so when the flap is flipped up.
Really, with the board screwed on the back of it, probably right there.
Yeah, if you're screwing it on that way. Yeah. It's a support structure for the next eel that we're foaming. I'm waiting on my eel to dry. There are 43 really quiet people watching, but I haven't been watching the comments very well either. So there you go. Meant to dry. Have a dance party. All right, so let's look at our head shape and see if I have to make anything else. Hello, John C. Good to hear from you, buddy. You get an Allen fist bump because I don't have a Beastman fist bump at work. Much more pronounced ridge over the eyes on these snakes. I think, sick move, that's right. I think that I'm gonna cut a couple pieces just for that. Haven't lived till you stuck your hand into contacts and then covered couch foam. Okay, you be loud. You might note when I am cutting wood, cutting foam on the saw, I'm not holding on to it very tightly because if you're cutting wood and it rips the wood out of your hands and starts spinning the wood around, that can hurt you. If it starts spinning the foam around, that's the best possible option. That's not going to hurt me. So I'd rather have it rip the foam out of my hand and flop the foam around rather than hold on to it so tightly that it pulls my hand into the blade. Where that came from, but that wrapping around the blade and getting sucked up in there is bad. It just suddenly appeared right here. It stuck to my foam. Possible.
I have a blue thumb.
I see. Yes. Hello, Mario. Bye, Jennifer. Yes, it can certainly grab the wood you're cutting and cause problems. These are my over eye ridges. And I'm wondering how they have to be shaped. I think that they have to be on this side, like this way. So now I have this. Will glue down very well to the top. Yeah, I guess all the way around is how I'm gonna have to do that. And then I'll cut out some of the middle. Perfect. Snakes have vipers have a nice ridge over their eyes, and that's what I'm going to do with this piece of foam, is make that ridge.
Eels do not. Eels are like face, 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 eyes. They are set.
That is a little wet still right there. Now I'm getting that snake shape that I want back here with its head much wider up on that side. That's what I want. That one is pretty good.
Yes, I cut EVA on the bandsaw. That sounds pretty cool, Tank. I like two fingernails out of the same finger. Okay. Yeah, we're real close to 1 o'clock. Wait. It's 1 o'clock? That means it's lunchtime. Eventually I'll leave. Is it lunchtime, Rue? Okay, let me attach this. Sail! Sail! Made it. Sail. What? It looks like a sail.
See that?
Another song called Sail! Well, it's gonna be a head bump.
Oh. You're
making the bump.
This way with that triangular head. I'm probably going to come in here and take out a little bit of this to widen the nose out. Just a bit. Yeah.
You can over stuff it up.
Probably put something in there to spread it out wider. I need this to be a little, this is very rounded up top and they're very flat up top. With something that does one of those.
Yeah.
Anyway. All right, gang. So I think I'm going to cut off there. Much to do. Maybe I'll go live later. Bye. Rue, what do we say?
Go make stuff!
This is Cyclops.
Have a great afternoon, guys. I'm going to go eat lunch with probably Rue. Go make stuff.